guys. Time for another update. I'm still doing some experimentation with the video settings, so any tips, any help, any suggestions, any thoughts, anything you have to offer would be greatly appreciated. I'm still trying to get it right, but I'm going to do another one of these fairly quick updates with a few movies, and we'll see how it turns out. First one, Rec or Record, depending on who you ask. Now, I saw this before I saw Quarantine, and I do prefer this. I know that's weird because they are basically the same movie, but there's just something about this one. This movie gets to me. It makes me nervous while I'm watching it. That's great, because it's rare. And if you haven't seen this, I highly recommend checking it out. This is a great movie. It took me a long time to finally buy it, but now I finally got it, rewatched it, still works. Really creepy. Terror unfolds in real time. Very solid movie. Not going to get into it too much. It's been discussed a lot. It's been out for a while. Part 2 is available in some places now. I'm waiting for it to come out. There's nothing wrong with it. I got nothing bad to say about it. It's a great movie. If you haven't seen it yet, highly recommend checking it out. Next one, on the other hand, a little something called Creepshow 3. And yes, this is made by the same two people responsible for Day of the Dead 2 Contagium. But I knew what I was getting into. It's called Creepshow 3, but it's not Creepshow 3. It's a low-budget anthology from two people who maybe think a little bit more of themselves than they should. And I waited for it to get real cheap. It was $5.99. Fair enough. So I can finally see it for myself and see what I think. Nobody likes it. I can understand that too. But going in with the expectations I went in with, it was okay. It had its moments. It wasn't a complete waste. I'm definitely not recommending it to anybody, but I'm probably going to hold on to it. I just wish these people would learn how to shoot a night scene. You know, it's a horror movie, okay? But it's got five stories. First one is this cracked out Alice in Wonderland-esque thing. I'm not even going to get into that one. The second one is about a guy who picks up a radio that starts guiding his life, telling him what to do, and is very interested in diversifying. Okay. Third one is about a serial killer call girl who gets with a client that maybe is more than she can even handle. Fourth one's called Mail Order Bride. And it's about a girl who may or may not be a robot, but two guys trying to find out if she is makes for one of the gorier, over-the-top, hilarious, troubling moments in the entire movie. And the fifth story is about this butthole doctor who's got a real attitude, hates people, and gives this bum a hot dog that he drops on the street, and the guy dies and starts kind of haunting him. Very lame attempt to recreate the Thanks for the Ride Lady story from a much better Creepshow film. And that's this one. It's got some extras. It's got a making of. I don't know. I don't recommend it to anybody. It was $6. I got it. I'm glad I got it. I'm glad I finally saw it. I wanted to. It's about time I did. But again, I knew I wasn't watching a real Creepshow movie. I knew they just had access to the Creepshow title and that's as close to connected to Creepshow as this is, besides being an anthology. So, and don't look for any of that animation. There's a little computer animation at the beginning, and really, that's about it. But, Creepshow 3. Next one. This is a real surprise. Don't go by the title on this. I gotta talk about this one a little bit. This is a Japanese movie from Naoki Kudo, starring Shinya Hashimoto, called Oh! My Zombie Mermaid. Now, Shinya Hashimoto, is apparently a very famous wrestler in Japan. A lot of these people are celebrities in Japan, singers, wrestlers, different things. First thing, there are no zombie mermaids in this movie. That's just marketing garbage. There is a zombie, there is a mermaid, but there's no zombie mermaids. The original title translates into something like, Ah! House of Wrestling. And it's a quality film. It's great. It's got action and stunts and comedy and horror and violence and cool makeup effects and the whole, practically the whole second half is an extended action scene as he goes through this sort of Game of Death-esque scenario and to fight for his wife, who he's in love with, who has contracted a very rare, and I mean very rare, infection that starts turning into a mermaid. And this shady TV producer, he's a real butthole anyway, he's real snarky, and he wants to televise the whole thing to just to make money. And he doesn't care who gets hurt or who's upset. And I gotta tell you, I can't stress this enough, it's a quality film. It's really good. It's got heart. It's got a lot of things you might not be expecting it to have, including some decent extras. It was fun to watch some of the, like when they did the premiere, there's one of my favorite fight scenes in the movie, actually, where somebody comes to his rescue, sort of, and takes on, yeah, I better not get into that, kind of a spoiler, but she's got the ninja thing going on. Very cool movie, really difficult to classify, pretty tough to explain, but yeah, do check this one out. Be open-minded and check it out. Don't go exactly by the title, which is inaccurate anyway, and see what you think. This is good stuff. Really, really satisfying movie. Very exciting, well-made, good stuff. Oh, My Zombie Mermaid. Check that one out. Next is a Hong Kong movie. I never thought I would get back. This is very hard to come by, but I got lucky. It's nice to have friends. Enter the Eagles, starring Shannon Lee, daughter of Bruce Lee, and they really play up that fact in her first fight, and then they kind of let it go. Stars Michael Wong, also, who's great. It's directed by Corey Yuen. Another Corey Yuen movie back in my collection. That's the way it should be. The bad guy, one of the bad guys, Benny the Jet Urguidez. Very cool. Heist, action, martial arts, thriller, combo, spy, but highly recommended for Hong Kong film fans. Nothing wrong with this one at all. Very, she's great too. I wish she had done more starring stuff. If you run across a movie on Sci-Fi Channel called Epoch, she's in it for about 2 seconds. That's kind of what she's done. You know, it's too bad. She's great. Very good movie. Enter the Eagles. But tough to come by. Next one, speaking of Sci-Fi Channel, Ogre. Unrated version of Ogre. It says, no donkey, no fairy tale, just terror. That's classic. I saw this on Sci-Fi Channel some time ago when it premiered, and I actually thought it was pretty decent. You know, the story's a little tighter than usual, the acting's a little better than usual than a lot of these. Even the CG on the Ogre is really not that bad. As far as those movies go, the Sci-Fi Channel premiere movies, it's pretty entertaining. You gotta remember, I mean, these are TV movies made on the quick and on the cheap. And the funny thing about Ogre, oh, and Catherine Isabel is in it, from Ginger Snaps. But the funny thing about this is, it's basically, and obviously, their version of The Village if something was actually going on in the village. So it's a village lost in time, and they have to make sacrifices for this ogre to stay alive and not get this plague. And obviously there's some gore, it's not great. But it's fun, as long as you know what you're getting into. Sci-Fi Channel type movie. Do not mind this movie. Like the ogre, kind of fun. After my last update, I actually got emails saying, so what's up, no Switchblade? You didn't show any Switchblade titles. Well, there are more coming, believe me, and a fair amount too. But right now I'm trying to keep the updates sort of quick, get through them, show a few movies, talk about them a little bit, not heavy on the information or anything. Mostly trying to get the video settings right while getting some movies shown so I don't fall too much further behind. So I hope this worked out, but I guess we'll see when I put it up. Let me know what you guys think, alright? Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you next time. Later.